guys, this is Vijayta and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make this mandala, how to draw a mandala basically for absolute beginners. Somebody who has never tried mandala, I think this video is for them. I have made the other video also if you want to check that out, and I have gotten a lot of questions, people asking that this is not something for the beginner, I cannot draw. I have come with a better solution for everybody who find that video a little difficult to follow. I will show you much simpler techniques to draw a mandala like this with the help of only three shapes: lines, dots and petals. So these are the three shapes that I have used in this design, and let's start the video without any delay. First of all, you need a paper. This is a cartridge sheet. So I am using an A4 cartridge sheet. Don't worry, I will put all the links in the description, whatever stationery and supplies that I'm using to draw this mandala. So you can check them out if you want to buy it from Amazon. The second thing that you need is a compass. So I am using Faber-Castell drawing instrument box. This comes with a set, so I just find this simpler than buying things separately. So I need a pencil, I need a compass, I need a protractor, and I need a ruler. I also need a pen. Okay, about the pens. So I have already done a video on what are the best pens for drawing and calligraphy. You can check that out. But right now I can show you three options that you can use. My favorite is this one. As you can see, this is Staedtler's pigment liner. So this one does not fade away. If you want to paint after drawing your mandala, so you can use watercolor, poster color, any sort of color over it. This will not smudge. So this one is my favorite. I'm going to use 0.8. This is one option. This is another option. This one is Micron 0.08, and this is also pigmented liner. So if you don't find that one, you can go for this one, but I prefer this one because this one dries up very easily. Last one is Faber-Castell multi marker. This is an OHP marker. It is supposed to be used as a permanent marker, but this one is an affordable option. This comes for I think 25 to 30 rupees. It's very pigmented, but it slightly fades away and it bleeds also. So if you're looking for an affordable option, I think this is decent for practicing. So now we are just gonna start. Okay, I'm sorry, there is also fourth option, which is a sketch pen. I think a lot of us don't have a pen. If you don't have a gel pen, you can also use gel pen or ball pen. But if you want to use something bolder, then you can use this sketch pen also. So these are the things that you need to draw a mandala. I know that's a lot, but you gotta do it. I mean, until and unless you're drawing a freehand mandala, you might not need a ruler or a compass or a protractor, but you do need a pen and pencil. So let's quickly start drawing the guidelines for mandala. Okay, so this is my A4 sheet, and I'm gonna take a center point of the sheet. Okay, so it's 21. I am going to take a 10.5. Just for your clarity, I am darkening it. First thing you need to do is put the pencil in the compass. My compass is ready. I'm going to take 3 centimeter. I'm going to make a circle of 3 centimeter radius, which means 6 centimeter of diameter. This is my circle. I am making it dark so that you all can see it. I mean, you don't have to make the guidelines this dark. It is just for tutorial purpose. Draw a straight line from the center of the circle. Okay, so this is my straight line. Once you're done doing this, take the protractor and divide the half circle into 9 equal parts. Just take a distance of 2 cm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Repeat the process to the other side. Basically, you need to divide the whole circle into 18 parts. Now what we need to do, we need to draw a straight line for this. So I'm gonna just join these lines, and it's okay, go as long as you wish because your mandala is going to be big. just join these lines. That's what we are gonna use for drawing the shape of mandala. These are the guidelines, guys. So this is very important. Honestly, it doesn't have to be very accurate because you're not sitting in a geometry class. The next step is, this is my center part of the circle. So I'm gonna start from here. I'm gonna take my base, take the point from this section. I just follow, you know what I'm trying to say. And then this is like what, 3 centimeter? So I'm gonna just draw a circle, draw a half circle, and then this was your point. Now leave one section and start drawing the same thing from the second division. So I have, let me just mark these points. So after every 2 divisions, just take a point, take a center point, I don't know what to call it, like that, and then put your compass on it and start drawing this half circle. Now what you're supposed to do, the same point that you took, just do the same thing from the other side. Are you able to follow me, guys? Because I'm sorry, I just don't know how to explain this, but yeah, this is pretty much how this is supposed to be. So this is going to be my guideline. The next thing that I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just take whatever distance that this shape is intersecting at, I'm gonna draw a circle from there. Okay, so wherever these are intersecting, I know these are not intersecting exactly on the guideline, but that's okay. So these are the places where these shapes are intersecting. I'm gonna take this and this as a distance. Okay, and I'm gonna draw like this. I'm gonna draw an arc, and from here I'm gonna draw another arc. Just draw a shape, and then take this and draw an arc from here. I hope this is kind of understood how this is done. Okay, so this is my final mandala. Okay guys, so I am done erasing the guidelines that I have drawn. I only have the shape of the mandala now. So I have put this pen inside my compass, but you can avoid that. I mean, you can draw by freehand also. I'm gonna draw the outline one more time with the pen. Okay, this is just to show you if you are not able to do it freehand, but I prefer doing it freehand. I'm gonna draw a very tiny circle in the center. Just draw these petals. I'm gonna draw another circle under it, under the flower that I had made. See, this is one way to add detailing. This is outlined. There are 3 patterns that I am going to use. So first pattern that I'm gonna use is lines. This is how I'm gonna fill most of the shapes. The second pattern that I'm gonna use is, I'm gonna do dots on the edges. Lines, dots. And the third pattern that you can do is draw these petals. This is optional. You can choose to use it or you can avoid it. Petals. These are the only 3 patterns that I'm gonna use in this mandala. Let's just start. I need to do a straight line. See, I'm doing it freehand, but because I'm comfortable in it, but you can choose to use a ruler if you want. So this is how I'm gonna fill the shape. Thank you. Other thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use dots. See, now you just have to follow it. I mean, you know what I'm doing and you just have to follow. Okay, so the center part is done. Okay, so this is my shape. Let me just first make it bold. When you make a shape bold, it becomes neater. Whatever shaky lines that you have drawn, you can just make the lines bold, then it wouldn't show. Any which way, mandalas are supposed to be therapeutic. You're supposed to enjoy the process. You're not supposed to think about how it's going to end up looking, because it's supposed to relax. Even right now when I'm drawing it, I am not worried how this is going to end up looking. I'm just drawing it. So for this shape, what I thought is I'm gonna make just one petal. I am going to fill this up. So when you're drawing a petal and if you're not sure it is in shape, so it's okay, just fill the shape and then I'm gonna draw lines around it. That's it. You might have noticed that I'm rotating the paper while drawing it. That's also okay. It's okay to rotate the paper. Just make yourself comfortable. For the bigger petal, I'm going to make this bold again. And then I'm going to draw a shape inside it. Okay, so we are going to repeat the same pattern on this outer shape. I'm gonna make this bold and then I'll draw another shape inside it. See, if you're not able to do this shape by yourself, take a distance from here, wherever you want to start the shape from, whatever distance you want to take, and then draw like this. Make the same arc from here. You can draw it with the help of compass also, if you're not able to draw it freehand. So let's just quickly fill this shape. See, all I'm using is the lines that I told you about. I am not using petals, but if you want to use petals and if you can draw it, maybe you can use that also. This is for people who cannot draw petals. So this is like that. This is my shape that I'm going to repeat all over the place, but I'm gonna embellish it with dots at the edge. I do not think that you need to be a professional artist to be able to draw a mandala. I think anybody can draw it. It's very simple. You just need to follow some easy steps, which is why I am here to help you guys, and you will be able to draw one mandala, beautiful mandala, in no time. I think it's a very beautiful exercise. Everybody who is stressed, it would be a very good exercise for them to relax their mind. In fact, even if you have a coloring book, a mandala coloring book, that can also work. That can also de-stress you. Like, I am drawing right now and I'm just so much at peace. Honestly, I'm not lying. I'm actually feeling good about it. To be honest, I have not used any other shape but lines and dots. So for someone who wants to just play around with simple shapes and do not want to worry about the difficult patterns that we have, so this could be a good start. So I feel this is looking a little empty. I'm gonna draw a circle, but if you can make a flower inside it. So I'm almost done with this. If you want a PDF file of this artwork, I will share it in the description, and I will also share a pattern sheet. So it's a pattern library for mandala. It's for free. You just have to download it from my Google Drive, and I will also share a practice sheet with it. Like the video only when you like this. I don't think people share the videos these days, but if you can, I would like it if you share the video with your friends and family and anybody who wants to learn mandala. If you're not my subscriber, please subscribe to my channel. And that's about it. I will see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.